On his first visit to the Defense Language Institute since taking charge of the U.S. Army Intelligence Center of Excellence, Brigadier General Anthony Hale wanted to learn more about the Institute and how students are faring during the pandemic.
What we've seen here at DLI and my team was able to get a good understanding of today is how DLI has adapted to the COVID situation and gone to more virtual training, how they were able to do that in a very short time, as all DLI students are issued laptops and computers and iPads, and how we used the Microsoft Teams to do that instruction via virtual training.
The visit on January 4th included lunch at the Presidio of Monterey's new dining facility, Che Hall, as well as a walkthrough in the barracks where students are housed two to a room.
As a leader, I want my subordinate leaders to be positively intrusive as a leader with their soldiers, their sailors, their airmen, and their Marines. And what that means is really knowing their soldiers, knowing how they're doing in the classroom, for one, but knowing a little bit about their family, knowing a little bit about some of the issues that they may be dealing with.
The Defense Language Institute is an Army-run organization, but all four military branches send service members to do language training at Monterey. General Hale used the opportunity to meet with their leadership. Hale spoke about the need to teach new service members, regardless of branch, and prepare them to be good leaders.
This is only their second assignment after basic training, or their first assignment after basic training, so we're transitioning them from civilian to military life. And that's a little bit different than being in high school or being in college. And it's some of the different challenges that they have to deal with. That positively intrusive leader gets to understand some of the things that are affecting their organization.
Addressing the effects of coronavirus, Hale spoke about the difficulties students are facing.
COVID has affected us in many ways, but one is the isolation. And going to virtual training, our students stay in their rooms for learning 7 hours a day, plus their homework assignments, additional 3 hours a day. So they're isolated from their peers, they're isolated from their leadership, but that positively intrusive leader is the one who's always there, who's checking up on them, who's talking to them in a meaningful way, who's understanding their issues, and just really being there for them as that positively intrusive leader.
In his parting remarks, Hale said he thought that we are turning the corner regarding the pandemic situation.
So I would tell you that I think that the next couple of months are going to be tough with the COVID environment across the nation. But I think we as a Department of Defense and as a military are taking some good mitigation measures to make sure that we protect ourselves as much as possible. And that's protecting not only our student population, our young soldiers, but also our faculty, our civilians, our dependents that transition DLI on a daily basis. I would tell you that I believe we're turning the corner, but their ability to learn their skill set, to learn their language, is only going to help them be a better service member. We're depending on them to learn their language, to support our operations worldwide, whether it be as a cryptologist linguist, or whether it will be as a linguist in a operational unit that could perhaps be deployed at some point in the future. And what they're learning here at DLI is critical to our mission as a nation.